Hi everyone! In this video, I am going to provide 10 tips to help you become more effective at doing literature searches using Google Scholar. When I did my degree 25 years ago, the challenge was to find information. Today is the opposite. Today, the challenge is how to deal with information overload. There's simply too much information around, and therefore it makes it harder to identify what is really relevant for our research. Learning and applying the 10 hacks that I'm going to share with you in this video will help you to increase the speed with which you can find relevant information, while at the same time identify relevant literature that perhaps otherwise you would miss. I'm Miguel Moital. I am the founder and chief content developer of the Dissertation Academy. And in the Academy, we are all about bringing you unique tips and tools to help you write a better dissertation. So if you're new here, consider hitting that subscribe button. I'm going to divide the tips into four areas: words to use during the initial search, how to narrow down the search, how to reduce the number of relevant hits, and finally, some tips that involve looking at related published work. Let's start with the words to use during the initial search. Tip number one is to use common sense words. So the example here is a student who wanted to look at the tradition side of brands, brands that have a past and how they use them for branding. So she started with the common sense expression of brands with tradition. So let's go to Google Scholar. And once in Google Scholar, we are going to type brands with tradition. If we press enter, there are around 230,000 hits. Obviously, this is too much and we need to start narrowing this down. When you start, the objective is to arrive at an area of the academic literature that is relevant to your study. And this requires identifying the wording, i.e. the academic designations, the language used by academics to refer to that area. In this particular case, we are interested in what gives value to these traditional brands. If we scroll down, we can see that there's lots of research using the word tradition, but really there's not a lot related to what we are trying to find out, what makes a traditional brand. Page number two confirms the results of the first page. There aren't really any articles that use the word brands and tradition in the title. So that's perhaps a hint that we need to use a different word to search. So how can we use the search that we've already done to help us find that expression, that academic area that we are really interested in? This is tip number two, which involves getting inspiration from words in the research results. If we keep looking at the different pages, we actually see in page three a different word, and that word is heritage. So that gives us a hint that perhaps the word that we are looking for is not so much tradition, but the word heritage. So what we can do next is to do a new search using the words brand and heritage. So let's do it and see what comes up. Et voila! Just looking at it straight away, we conclude that we may well be on the right track. The word heritage brands features in the title in all of these sources. That's a very good sign that we've probably arrived at the right wording. Tip number three is checking synonyms of those common sense words that we've started with. So we can start with our initial common sense expression or word and go to Google, normal Google, and use a thesaurus to identify other words that can be used to refer to the same thing. And if we do that for the word tradition, we actually see that the word heritage is related to tradition. So we could, if we hadn't done tip number two yet, we could have gone to a thesaurus and checked for similar words and used those in our Google Scholar search. The next two tips are about helping you to narrow down your search. So tip number four is about using Google recommendations. And there are two types of recommendations. There are common recommendations that Google Scholar provides you as you type your search, and there are also recommendations in the search results. Let's look at each of those and see how helpful they can be. So here you can see that there are five suggestions: heritage brands, automotive industry, heritage brands, luxury industry, heritage brands, fashion, heritage brands, consumer perceptions, and heritage brands, royal. If we go back to the original expression, brands with heritage, there are actually no suggestions. So this is a good sign that you need to play with words so that the system can recognize your expression and give you suggestions. If we scroll down to see the second type of suggestions, we see that there are more suggestions. For example, British heritage brands identities, heritage brands motivations, and also heritage brands authenticity. So in the related searches area, which comes in the middle of the first search page, you can identify additional subsets of the initial word or expressions that you used in your search. And if you click on the suggestion, it takes you to the results that are associated to that particular search. These two recommendations from Google are particularly important when you are exploring a topic. It's almost like you don't need to think too much because Google does some of the thinking for you. So use the system to your own benefit. Tip number five involves adding the word and. This means you can bring together two expressions and Google Scholar is going to pick up the different expressions that you are using. Let's continue with our example. If we search, for example, using the word heritage brands and factors, and must be in capital letters, let's see what comes up. Here we are using the word factors because what we want to do is to look at those factors that provide brands with heritage, with tradition. So as you can see, Google is providing you with sources that include those two expressions, heritage brands and factors. And actually the first reference seems to be a useful one because it talks about the drivers and outcomes of brand heritage. So it may well be that those are the things that we are interested in. So we could click on it and check if those drivers and outcomes are the things that we are interested in, i.e. what makes a brand have heritage value, tradition value. Tips number 6, 7, and 8 are about reducing the number of relevant hits. As you can see, a normal search brings up thousands, tens of thousands, or even millions of hits, and therefore we need to find ways of reducing those hits and so that, you know, the most relevant ones remain. Tip number 6 is about using quotation marks. When you use, for example, heritage and brands, the system is going to pick up anything that has the words heritage, the words brand, and the expression heritage brand. But that's not what you are interested in. You are interested in the expression itself, heritage brands. So one way of telling the system that you just want literature that includes those words in that order is by using quotation marks. If we don't use quotation marks, we get 157,000 results, which is way too much. We can't deal with such a large amount of information. So let's see what happens when we use quotation marks and tell the system, no, I just want references with the exact expression, heritage brands. We went from over 150,000 to 1,270. Not only it is much more manageable, but we are more confident that those that remain are the ones that will be useful for us. Once you have a go at using some of these tips, let me know in the comments how useful they have been to you. Did they help? Did they help you to navigate through the sheer amount of information that exists out there? Did you find them challenging? And if you have any questions about the tips, do feel free to ask them and I'll provide my advice to the best of my ability. Tip number 7, searching on the title only, helps us to reduce the number of hits even more. In principle, we can assume that if our expression is in the title, then the entire paper is about that expression. And therefore, we are more certain that we will find what we want in that paper. Because heritage brands, the expression itself, could be just at the end of an article as a suggestion for future research. We are looking for articles that are totally or entirely or almost entirely devoted to the topic of interest, in this instance, heritage brands. So what we can do is to go to the advanced capabilities of Google Scholar and tell the system, give me just the hits that include our expression in the title. To do so, you go to these three lines, which opens up a menu, and you then click on Advanced Search. And in the advanced search, you have several options, and the one that we are interested in is where my words occur. At the moment, it's set for anywhere in the article, but we want to shift that to in the title of the article. So let's see how much reduction we get. Actually, we went from over 1,000 results to 64 results. And therefore, we went from over 150,000 to 64 that appear to be highly relevant for our study. By using these two tips, tip number 6 and tip number 7, we reduced the number of hits significantly, making our life a lot easier. If you are enjoying this video, don't forget to do a like, as this will greatly help the video to gain visibility and also help the channel to grow. And if you think that some of your friends will benefit from watching it, why not sharing the link with them? We can reduce this number further by using tip number 8. Tip number 8 is about time restriction. We can restrict our searches by, for example, looking at just recent searches or older searches or searches, during a specific period. Google Scholar gives us a suggestion straight away, since 2017, since 20, or since 2021, but we can also tell the system a custom range. And here we can say, I just want studies from 2010 onwards, and leave the second date open, and then we do another search, and we will only get the studies published since 2010. The number went down to 51 results. Tips number 9 and 10 are about looking at related work that has been published. Tip number 9 is related to the ability to identify related articles. Let's say you find a reference that appears to be very useful for your study. Google tells you what related articles are there. If you click on the related articles option, you get around 100 results of articles that appear, according to Google Scholar, that appear to be related to the article that you are interested in. Tip number 10 is the ability to search for material that has been published after the article. In other words, material that cites the article that you are interested in. And just below the reference, you can also see an option which says cited by, and then the number of articles that have cited that reference. And again, we are going to click on the first reference in our search. We see that now we have the 519 references that have cited the article that we are interested in. And the cleverness of Google Scholar is that you can now search within citing articles. So if you click on that option, so there's a box at the top that allows you to do a search within the, in this case, 519 results. Let's say we are interested in the word factors again. So let's do a search using the word factors. So we reduced our number of hits to 285. That's all for now. Thank you very much for watching the video. Don't forget to like the video if you enjoyed it. And also there are other videos that you can watch to help you write a better dissertation. Thank you very much, and I'll see you at the next video.